I bought one of the absolute cheapest point-to-point wireless bridges that you can buy on AliExpress, and we're gonna try to set it up and see how it works. Setting up a point-to-point wireless bridge can be a tricky task, especially if it's not something that you're used to doing. That's where the good folks at Rogue Support can help. If you're looking to extend your internet connection to an outbuilding or set up some cameras at the remote end of your property, you want to make sure that you're picking the right equipment and configuring it properly. So open up a ticket with Rogue Support and we'll make sure that your point-to-point wireless bridge is designed and installed correctly the first time. Just visit us on the web at rogue.support to get started today. You won't be disappointed. All right, so this is the Koofy wireless bridge outdoor. It says for 1 kilometer/5 kilometer long distance, IP65 waterproof, so this is made to go outside. And this is a two pack that I got for just under $35 shipped. All right, looking at the back, we see PoE power, 1 to 5 kilometer transmission, one key bridge, whatever that means, 300 megabit data rate, and then it says 2.4G/5.8G, which is weird. It actually says that in a couple places around the box. So I don't know if this is selectable for what band you actually use, or I don't know, but it also has a, looks like gigabit Ethernet port, and it says high gain antenna, and of course, perfect for your villa, your mountain area, or your port. All right, so let's get this thing out of the box. Okay, so we've got some instructions. Oh, look, I got a little keychain. That's nice. A couple of, are these PoE injectors? Oh yeah, look at that, little PoE injectors. Okay, that's cool. So it comes with two PoE injectors. And then we have our two antennas. Oh, it looks like there's some more stuff under here as well. Oh, it comes with Ethernet cables and a couple of huge tie straps here. Oh, three tie straps. All right. Oh, four tie straps. All right, so that's nice. It actually does come with everything that you need to get these installed. We do have some information about the default IP address that are the same on both, so we'll have to set up one and then set up the other. Okay. Oh, and it's got two Ethernet ports. Okay, so look at this. Two Ethernet ports, and there is a selector switch that says M/S. All right, so one of the ports says WAN/PoE, and the other says LAN. There's a reset switch, a DC input, and then again, that M/S. I wonder if that means like medium range or short range. Let's see what this says in the instructions here. Oh, I see, the MS is master slave. Okay, so the master slave bridge can be set to bridge one. All right, so one click fast pairing. Let's try this. We'll use one as master. This one that I opened will be the master. So let me put that to M. And then this other one here. And this one, I guess I will put to S. So one was set to M and one was set to S out of the box. First, press and hold the RST key on the master router for 1 to 3 seconds and release it. Within 1 minute, press and hold the RST key on the slave router for 1 to 3 seconds and release it. Wait 1 minute and the two bridges will be successfully paired. Okay, so I brought out a power strip, I plugged in both of the PoE injectors, and I plugged cables from the PoE side of the PoE injectors to the WAN/PoE port on each of these devices. We can see that they both have green lights going. This one just has the Wi-Fi blinking really fast. This is the master side, and it said hold down the reset button for 1 to 3 seconds on the master first. So let's do that, see if I can get a good shot here. One. Two, three, stop. And then on the slave for 3 seconds. One, two, three, stop. And then it says it takes up to 1 minute to pair. Right now I don't see any lights happening on either of these devices. Oh, now it looks like the master is cycling, doing some sort of cycling. It might have actually paired out of the box. It kind of looked like it was paired. And then maybe the reset button repairs it. Like maybe it comes paired out of the box. Or when you just first power them up and turn them on, they automatically pair with each other if they don't have an existing configuration. All right, so it looks like that worked. I don't know how easy this is to see, but we do have full signal strength indicators. Oh, let me get some shadow on it. There we go. It does have full signal strength indicators on both of these devices. So in the meantime, I brought my laptop over. I plugged my laptop into the LAN port of the PoE injector for the master device, and it says you need to configure your laptop in the 192.168.188.x network, so let's do that now. All right, network and internet settings, Ethernet, edit, manual, IPv4, 192.168.188. We'll call it 99. 255.255.255.0. That should be good enough. And it says that the device is supposed to be 192.168.188.253. So let's try going there. Oh, looks like it's working. Hey, there we go. All right, and the password it says is, admin. All right, very secure. All right, so we'll say admin, login. Oh, there we go. Yeah, so it is connected, and they are actually paired. Look at that. Now, we want to change it because right now they probably both have the same LAN IP address of 192.168.188.253, so we're going to want to change one of these. So let me go over here to network, connection GHCP. Is that supposed to be DHCP? Okay. Static IP. All right, so let's call this one 254. In fact, let me put it in my 200 network. We'll just give it 200.90 and then 200.91 on the other one with a gateway. It says primary and secondary DNS. It says no need, don't fill. All right, so we'll apply that, and then I should have to change my laptop here. It looks like it worked. So it tried to redirect. So rather than change my laptop into the 200 network, I'm going to switch my laptop to the other device, the other side of this wireless bridge, which still shows connected according to the LEDs on the side. But now let's go back to 188.253 again. This is on the secondary device. Or did that change the IP of both sides? Hang on a second. I'm going to manually put my computer into the 200 network here, 200.99. We're going to save that. And can we bring up 200.90 from the slave device? 200.90. Oh, interesting. All right. Let's see if we can see IP addresses for both sides. Device info. So I'm plugged into the slave device and it says 200.90. Where can we see the actual? Oh no, look, because it says device 1 access point mode 192.168.188.100, device 2 repeater mode 192.168.200.90, but they are working. What the heck? Huh. Well, let's do this. I'm going to plug one of these, I'm going to plug the master device, since I'm already plugged into the slave device, I'm going to plug the master device into my 192.168.200 network, and then let's see if we can actually get to the internet. So let's see, my laptop is statically set without a gateway. Hang on, let me see if I can switch my laptop to DHCP now. That's what's going on. All right, so we're going to say automatic save. Oh, and it's working. Wow, look at that. Okay, so it is absolutely working. So I've got my laptop plugged into the PoE injector of the slave device here. Yeah, this is the slave device. Wireless bridge over to the master device, which is plugged into the PoE injector. The LAN side of the PoE injector is going over to my switch over here, which of course has full internet access, and I am receiving replies from 1.1.1.1, and I'm able to pull up like /.org. I could pull up, I'm sure, Google. Yeah, that is working. Okay, well, that's great. Let's run a speed test. Okay, so this is our speed test out to the actual internet with speedtest.net, and it got us 60x43 or 58x43. Okay, interesting. Let's see if I can get to my open speed test server running on this Apple Mac Mini M2 here. Okay, so I have open speed tests running on the Apple Mac Mini. I have both devices plugged in and ready to do the speed test locally on the LAN. That Mac Mini has a 10 gig NIC, so that should be no bottleneck whatsoever. And let's go ahead and run the test. Keep in mind also that these are not pointing directly at each other. They're pointing up at the ceiling. So that might affect the speed a little bit. It's actually best with these point-to-point antennas if they're a little bit far apart and, of course, pointed directly at each other. And this time we ended up with 76 down and 82 up. Okay, so I'm trying to get as close to that 300 megabits that the box says these can do as possible, so I have set them up a little bit better. Now they're pointed at each other as best as I can with these little clamps here, and of course they're upright and now pointed directly at each other. They're about 3 to 4 feet apart. Let's run that speed test again. All right, so that time we got 81.7 by 72.3, which is about a third of where we should be considering these are boasting 300 megabits per second. Breaking in to do a quick note here about wireless speeds. Now, when a vendor says that you can get 300 megabits per second out of their wireless bridge, that number is actually a little bit misleading. They usually mean 300 megabits total, adding the send and receive traffic together. So in the case of this particular wireless bridge, the max that I would expect to see is about 150 megabits in one direction or the other. In my testing, I was barely able to get about 100 megabits, but you know, you get what you paid for, and honestly, that's still plenty of bandwidth for most normal wireless traffic. Okay, for 35 bucks, 80 megabit synchronous wireless bridge that was that easy to set up with just the touch of a button and changing an IP address in the interface, I really can't complain about that too much. Now, how they hold up over time is a different story. They are supposedly IP65 weatherproof, if we can trust that. But I'm sure, you know, under the eave of a roof or something like that, they'd be perfectly fine out in the elements for a good long time. If you just needed some point-to-point wireless connectivity to an area of your yard, you know, a barn or a gazebo or an outbuilding or a remote garage or something where you wanted to put a couple cameras, maybe an access point, for 35 bucks, these will work, and yeah, you can't really go wrong with that price, that's for sure. Okay, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you are subscribed to Crosstalk Solutions for more videos just like this, and like this video to show your appreciation for my $35 Alibaba purchase. And if you'd like to keep this party going, I have hand-selected a couple of videos on the right here for you to watch next. The top video is my review of the new Starlink Gen 3 satellite dish, and the bottom video is my review of T-Mobile's 5G home internet.